Hello and welcome again to another weekly health update. And today we're actually going to be discussing gastric reflux, otherwise known as GERD, otherwise known as acid reflux. My name's Dr. Matthew, and I'm very happy to be here so I can share with you some natural tips and treatments that you can do yourself at home, very, very inexpensive ways to help heal yourself of acid reflux. Now, 1 in 10 Americans actually has acid reflux, and I'm at WebMD right now, and many other sources say it's a little bit higher, around 1 in every 8 Americans. But the major reason why we have gastric reflux is because many of the sodas that we're drinking, the carbonated beverages, combined with the overeating of foods, combined with beer and many other things of that nature, what that does in many instances, the food doesn't get broken down like it should be in the actual stomach or the small intestine. And you have a couple conflicting theories about how gastric reflux start, but you ultimately have to look at the treatment and what works most effectively to really evaluate which ones are most plausible. But in my experience, and based on most of the credible research, gastric reflux most of the time results from lack of hydrochloric acid, not too much, as the pharmaceutical companies would have you believe many times. The reason why, now, if you take a medication or a pharmaceutical, the reason why you get the relief is because what happens normally is that we eat too much food, per se. And when we eat too much food, the stomach does not get digested within the gut. Ultimately, it sits there, it putrefies, and then it rots. So these particular prescription medications, what do they do? You take them and they inhibit these pumps of the stomach, so they get rid of all the acid. See, we have a little bit of acid even though we're still having the reflux, but these particular medications, many of them get rid of all of the acid. So the stomach basically freaks out. It says, "Oh my gosh, I need more acid." So it works really, really, really hard, and the cells get fatigued, but you get more acid within the stomach, and that's why you get relief of the symptoms. So, knowing and understanding that most cases of gastric reflux result from lack of hydrochloric acid within the stomach, let's go ahead and talk about some natural alternatives that you can do to help that. A very, very simple way to do, your first one you can try is apple cider vinegar. Now, this has been around for several hundred years, and many people have known about this. And the reason why it helps is because it's acidic. Now, it may burn a little bit as it goes down the esophagus, but wait about 30 to 45 seconds and you actually should start noticing relief. Typically, I recommend Bragg's apple cider vinegar. You can actually get that in a health food store. It's a very pure, very organic source of apple cider vinegar, and like I said, it will help the food get digested within the system. And one of the things you want to consider too, since here in America people eat too much, and it's obvious by the amount of overweight people and the obese epidemic we have, is that you want to make sure you cut down on your portions of food just a little bit. And I never, ever recommend eating within 3 hours of going to bed, simply because obviously if you eat a lot before you go to bed, you lie down, that sphincter, that upper esoph or that esophageal sphincter will not close properly, and it's really a partial sphincter, so it doesn't close like it should normally. But you want to make sure that you don't lie down directly after eating, especially if you're going to bed, because that can tend to precipitate it. So keep those things in mind. Another thing that I recommend are digestive enzymes. Typically, the food that we have in America, we don't, it's most of it's not organic, so it doesn't have the necessary enzymes and nutrients to readily pass things through the body. Now, a lot of your breads and your pastas, the reason why people are constipated most of the time is because these breads and these pastas, they don't have, per se, the enzymes to pass it through the gut. Whole grains are always better. Typically, excluding grains is really the best option, or getting sprouted grains, which are very, very hard to find. You can find Ezekiel bread at the store. That's actually a sprouted grain that I can think of off the top of my head. But what digestive enzymes do is they actually help to break down the food itself, and breaking down the food is going to obviously help things pass through the system. You can absorb things a lot better, and you won't have those problems. You can take the digestive enzymes, maybe one at the beginning of the meal and one maybe 15 minutes or halfway through the meal. Same with the apple cider vinegar. Many times you can actually take that about halfway through the meal, and that's what I found most effectively for patients of mine, and several other people that I know, and many, many other experts as well. So those are simple tips that you can do to reduce gastric reflux. Also, if you have any other questions, feel free to visit my website. It's actually to the right of this particular video. And I have a premier health website that offers free nutritional information. You can actually go here and you can click the register here link, and that will allow you to set up a profile that's specifically tailored to you. So I can tailor health information regardless if you're looking for natural alternatives. We want to be very specific with our approach, so you can check, and you know, if any conditions that you have or things like that, or if you're interested in nutrition or fitness, go ahead and check these, and we'll go ahead and send you the latest updated news on the health topics, alternative health, medicine, and fitness. And those of you that are not familiar, like I said, you can help and treat gastric reflux, acid reflux, or GERD naturally. And you don't have to go to the doctor and spend hundreds of dollars on these medications. You can treat it naturally. Now, if your gastric reflux gets to the point of where you get scar tissue, now then you might need your office, your medical doctor. They may have to do some surgical procedures because it can result in what's called Barrett's esophagus, which is just a chronic scarring of the tissue. You get like a spider webbed appearance within the esophagus. So we want to make sure that we prevent heartburn, gastric reflux from getting to that point. So if you start to notice symptoms, see your doctor immediately, but also keep in mind that you can help yourself naturally. So go check online, utilize some of the tips that I've just shared with you in this particular health update, and I'm certain you'll be very pleased and ultimately on your way to a new, vibrant lifestyle. Thank you.